Hi guys, welcome to a new video on Fake and Real Just For You. Today I'm going to show you something different and something fun, maybe, for some. So what I'm going to do is actually change this iPod, or AirPods, sorry, to black AirPods. Now the main reason is that these work good. The connection is good, everything's good. Only these black ones, I bought them and I used them and they were not good. They were stuttering every time and they stopped all of a sudden. I have no idea why. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to completely remove the inner workings from this AirPod to the black AirPod. And first things first is we actually need to check and see if these white AirPods are the same size as the black ones. Let's check. Actually look identical. First off, let's start with the right side. It's a slight difference. It does look like the black one is a little thinner. Let's check it out. So the first thing you do, twist the head downwards so you get this effect. Just pop it off. There we go. So we open that up. Same thing here. Twist it down. And pop it off. And be careful with that popping off. As you can see, this has a very small speaker compared to the other one. And still, it does look similar size-wise, but we're still going to test this out. So I'm going to open up the other one. Alright, so battery-wise, they're the same, but speaker-wise, the black one is much bigger. So I'm gonna try this one. There we go. You need to twist and then immediately open. Also, the same thing, the magnet also loose on the other side. So these both here, small speakers, big speakers. So that's a good thing. Now, battery size is still the same. Seems to be. Gonna check that out later. So first things first, I am going to dismantle the right side first and then do the others. But we're gonna skip the left side because it's gonna be exactly the same as the right side. So first we're gonna do the right side, dismantle the black one first. I'm going to use pliers or tweezers or whatever you want to call them. So first thing we do, oh crap, well, the best thing you can actually do is solder them off. So let's first heat up a soldering iron. Now you may be asking, why would you do this? Why? Well, one, it's more of an experiment to see if it works. And the second is I like the black color more. Then I actually like the white one. I'm just gonna go for it. All right, guys, we're back. So, heat it up, soldering iron. And now we're going to actually release this. Just be careful for the plastic. You don't want to melt the plastic as well. So, just remember where everything needs to go. So we got that out of the way. That's step one. So now we have the battery. So I have the soldering iron on 280. So I need to, doesn't have to be on high heat. No, that went well. Over there. Voila. So black goes here and the red one goes there. That's that. Over here. The next thing is actually the connection here. This tape here. Is a little sloppy. Still working there. So another piece here we can actually solder off. So, as you can see, all the cables here. So we have the, this is the antenna, the connection, the Bluetooth. We have the sound speakers cables, and then the actual battery cables. Now underneath here, we need to pull this out. Try to pry it out, something. This one is going very easy, by the way. So we're gonna find this out. And this is how it looks like. A very small, pretty effective system. You have the push function here. Funny how it looks like. But this one doesn't work properly. Separate from each other, it works perfect. But if you connect them together, and it just goes haywire. So that's that. I'm just gonna also remove the speaker here. A very big speaker, by the way. So the idea is actually to replace this and then put it in there, but hopefully it supports the speaker that I'm going to put in here. So just gonna leave this speaker in this earpiece here and put that back. See if this is right position. Sort of. Just turn this back up. Straighten that out. Voila. Hopefully it works. So now we're going to do the white one. This is gonna be a little tricky because the cable is a little bit on the inside here. Remember to watch out for the plastic covering. There we go. So that's how this one looks like. Small speaker. That one is the bigger one. Back for a minute. Remove this. We can actually pull this off. That actually works. Awesome. Put this right here. It's a bigger magnet than that one. Actually replace that. Oop, what are you doing? Don't want a shock over. Alright. Those cables are there. So we need to be careful with that. So I do think that the battery size of both of them are the same. So this one is green instead of white. But the cables are practically the same, blue and white for the speakers and red and black for the battery. So let's check. Nope. Damn it. I need to actually peel this back. Just a little bit, that would be perfect. Let's put this here. There. Alright. Slowly heat that up. Voila. There we have it. I'll just leave this like this. Put that side here. So now, we disconnected everything. Second thing is to actually pop this baby open. Oh. Alright, that's a... that is a big surprise. This one is kind of different from this one. That's the back, by the way. And just show the plus and minus here for the battery charging. Soldered on. That one is not. Kind of done that. Could have done it a little different. They could have put the soldering there and then use that space to increase the speakers or whatever. Well, anyway, in general, it does look the same. The push button is diagonal in this one. It's kind of cool. So, we have those two. Now, these are the covers. Now, as far as I can see, it does seem to be bigger, but hey, let's just try and fit it. Just try it. I'm going to put this here. Turn it the right way. Push button should go down. Well, so far so good. Does fit. That's good. It's a good sign. Peel out the cables a little bit. Then So what I'm going to do here is do a sign and check how this one looks like. So when you're looking straight to the letter here, should be horizontal. I'm looking straight here. I push it horizontally inside. I think I got that a little bit right. Maybe a little bit crooked. The shape is exactly the same, so that's good. It does fit. That's a good thing. I think I should later on I should glue that together so it stays there, or just lift up a little bit. And actually, I'm not sure if you can see it, but that push button there should be on the foil. Alright, so far so good. So we're going to separate all the cables. So I have the white one. I have a black one here. Red one. Alright, so these are for the speakers. These are for the battery. And this one is for the connection of Bluetooth. Alright, so just to see and check the difference between the battery. Now, this battery is how much? Oh crap, that's not a good deal. Don't touch those two together. That's not a good thing to do. Alright, so this one is a 3.430. How powerful is this one? Let's see. Also a 3.430. So no difference there. Battery is still the same. 49. Oh, yeah. It's exactly the same battery. So we're using the other one. I prefer that one. And because we removed the white one and we're going to reuse everything, we are definitely going to look at the charging connection. So you can use this one as reference if you lost it. So when we turn it this way, we have red on top and the black one on the bottom, but I do not see the plus minus, so really need to do it on the reference of the second part. So don't dismantle it all together at once, just do it one by one. Oh no, just here, just in front of the numbering, you can actually see the plus and the minus. So that's a good thing. So first thing I want to do is actually connect the speakers. Or no, let's do the cable here. Let's do this. So I'm gonna peel this off. Just don't want to melt it. So the green one here, just gently connect this together. Almost. Just really get it underneath there. You don't want the cable being on top. Check that out. Let me check that out. Yeah, that's good. So we soldered that. I'll put this back. Not yet going to push it real in there. It's very gentle. You never know, maybe a cable breaks. Hope not. So I chose to use this little puppy here. I'm going to use those speakers, so I hope it works. Let's find out. So first things first, and we're going to go from the inside, because we're actually going to close it, and this thing is not working with me. So I need something to secure it against. I'm going to use this. I'm going to use my hands here. It's pushing base. Alright, I'm going to solder this back. Now again, please be careful when you're using a solder iron. I do not have clamps. I know I should buy one. And yes, it does the job more easier if you have them. Alright, let's retry this. Where the hell are you going, man? Oh, for the love of God. Why aren't you? That's why you need some stabilizers. Oh crap. Alright, that's number one. Alright, this is definitely amateur hour, but I might need to clean it up. You need to use some. Cleaning engine. But this is Come on. A pretty good one. Got that one, finally. So now comes the battery. See, the plus is, where is it again? Oh, it's over there. These back together. Happy days. Ow. Come on. First. Like the silence can kill someone right now. It's kind of annoying to work with these fragile cables, but also can't overheat them, etc., etc., etc. So now, see if they work. So I have my phone here. I am actually going to connect it now. First thing, see if I can turn this on. So, turn it on. Just need to give it a little push.
connected. Just need to play a little bit just to connect these down. So, just connect to these. They are connected. Which one? Probably this one. Let's see. Ooh. I'm actually getting sound off this one. So let's just resolder this little puppy again. Mind the heck out of me now. This has a magnet on that side. Actually, it's annoying. The one thing I should never do, what I'm doing right now. Soldering something when it's still on. I'm a very stubborn person, so do not do what I'm doing right now. Please do not do what I am doing right now. Just enjoy what you're seeing. Just do not repeat. What this crazy person is doing. So, just gonna put a little bit of solder iron. Now we're gonna I'm not sure if you guys can hear it, but it's actually working. So, this is how you replace a white headset with a dark one. Now, you're going to do exactly the same thing with the other side. Now, if you're done with this whole idea of I've seen it, thank you very much, goodbye, I will tell you, thank you for watching. And happy toying. Just don't forget to put things back. And then, you know, try to do it yourself, or thank you for enjoying and give it a thumbs up for actually seeing that it's possible. It does work. So that's a good thing. So now I'm going to put everything back, and if you want to watch the whole video, I will also show you how I do the other side, how clumsy I am with the other side. With that being said, I am going to now put everything back. So this tape, we're gonna wrap around these cables and voila. Let's see here. We're going to push that up a little bit more. So now look at this one. Let's compare it. Yeah. The height is pretty much the same. I do think it should go a little bit higher. Just we can pick this up here. Don't break. Maybe. There we go. Just needed to give it a little twist. Again, amateur hours, guys. There we go. Yeah, that works. So double tap works again. Put everything back again. Now, as we can see here, we have the this one is left, and this one is the right side. So I'm gonna put the connection on the left. This one is left. Put the wire cable on the right, and the right on the left. Here's my thighs. Push it in there. Squeeze. Push those batteries in there. Bullshit. This back as well. So cables need to be squeezed in a little bit more. We're gonna perfect. They work. Now it's off. Now it's on. Still works. Need to. So, one thing I need to check. Because they should work. Magnetized does work on this one. So that's a good thing. So it sees it and it says it's charging. But the problem is it doesn't work. It doesn't fit this one because of the magnet position problem. It works, that's good. So we're gonna exchange this as well, but later on. First thing is still first. I am going to switch around the other one. So bear with me here. So this one is going to go with that one, yada yada yada. So we're going to remove these. So this one, also this. So, oh, that's not good. Remove it. Watch out for your cables. Perfect. All right, that's disconnected. There. Big magnet we're going to use you later. Alright, so now disconnect these two. Those two are also disconnected. All right. So we have the blue one here, and the green one over here. Do some brute force.
have to solder this off. Oop. So that just happened. Yet again, amateur hour. Thank you. See a little crack on this side. Didn't see that. So push it out. Voila. Some pliers to push. Twist it a little bit. And then just glide it out. So same thing here, looks exactly the same, not different than the other one. So this one works, this one we need to dismantle. Alright, so first things first, remove these. So the fun part is actually that you can reuse everything here. This one, this, and even the speakers you can reuse. If these one, you know, gets damaged or whatever, you can actually replace it. So when you're having a bad one, you should be happy because you have replacements now. If you find one online that is defect, you can actually buy one as for spare parts or even reuse parts that you need. So we have a battery, we have these beautiful speakers. Now I have to remove this one. Well, some of them you can reuse, not all. Oh, that's hot. Why didn't you let go? I don't know. There we go. Just need a little push. So that one is the other antenna. Could be possible that that was the problem. Could be possible that this was the problem for the whole system, but I don't, I'm okay with this. It works. It functions. I like it. So doesn't really matter. Maybe I'll just reconnect it and test it again and see what goes from there. So we're gonna peel out all the cables. All five of them. The first thing we're gonna do is push it in. Twist a little bit. And if we got the whole thing in there. Again, look at the letter there, and we're going to put the white line there, horizontal, push it back in. This one actually fits a little bit better. I do like it. We have the green one for the connection. Blue one for the speaker, white one for the speaker as well. Very good. So first thing I want to do is again do the connection. Or you know what, let's do the speaker first. That last one was kind of annoying. That took a lot. I want those cables inside, because actually when you push it back in, it doesn't stick out or bend the cable too much. So let's try this again. See if we can get it. No, it's moving. That's why we need clamps. They have anything to put underneath it, but maybe no, that's not gonna work. It's not gonna work as well. No, it's all not gonna work. Keeps turning. Alright, let's try again. Bless you. Okay, that worked. Alrighty then. That's good.
Different pliers, maybe? I think so.
Damn you, round shapes. Let's try this one. Yeah, I know. Amateur hour, we cover that already. Do this any longer, it's gonna break. By my hand. All right, let's try some. Shit, that's too much. Don't do this at home, John. Right. Finally, I got it. Very nice. I'm going to use this one.
side.
Cable away from everything. Push that down.
We do not need, don't forget the magnet. Now this one is positioned here, so this needs to be underneath so it clicks into its dock. So now comes the battery. Here it is here. Perfecto. Roll this up. Nicely. So, push cables upwards. Push this down. Position this correctly. Redo this. Cables here on top. I want it to be on this side. And when I push it back in, it goes into that small gap right on there. There you go. A little bit more pushing. Alright. So the bottom is good. Bring that up a little bit more. Nah, it's perfect. Shut up. Alright. So let's check. Connection now. Let's see if both of these. Oh crap. Forgot the magnet. Let me forget the magnet.
Right, so they are connected. Remove it. Shoot. Both of them. That's one. That's two. So we have now two working AirPods that we remove from these white ones to these beautiful black ones. The left one. Need to redo because change. Put this magnet here. No, don't do that. Damn it. Push it in position. Place. Push that back. Perfect. Now let's take our AirPod dock. Wrong way. Drop it. Over there. Cables back in there. Oh, are you serious right now? Alright, try this again. Knock inside. Are you kidding me right now? Can't get attached to it. Let's turn this around. Try this again. Finally. Jeez Louise. Alright. Now. So it does charge, so that's a good thing. So they're both charging now. But the thing is, I am going to remove my AirPods. Remove them. And I am going to reconnect them. See what happens. Oh. They work. So we're gonna open it up. Tell them to reconnect Apple AirPods. Connect, please. Let me show you guys as well. All right. They now reconnected. Alright guys,
I have shown you how to replace the AirPods. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is see if I can swap these out as well. But in general, it's not necessary because those go in here and they charge up. Same battery. So I'm first going to check if I can swap this around. And if yes, I will do it, and I'll also make a video of that. But in the meantime, just gonna enjoy my victory here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment section so everyone can answer them if others have the answers to it. If not, I will answer them, of course. Again, thanks for watching, and hope to see you guys next time. Take care.